Hello friends, I am NK Jain from Skill on Tech. Today I will explain you about double mechanical seal and what are the various arrangements of providing double mechanical seal in process pumps. Double or dual mechanical seal. You can see a picture of a double mechanical seal in this slide. In this picture you can see this is a pump side, means process side. And this is a atmospheric side. This is a rotating member and this is a stationary member. So this is the inboard of the mechanical seal and this outside which is towards atmosphere is called outboard of the mechanical seal. Here this is a rotating member and this is a stationary member. In these double mechanical seals, a buffer fluid or an external sealant is used to provide lubricate the mechanical seals. So, sometimes buffer fluid is used at a low pressure or otherwise barrier fluid or sealant is used at a high pressure to provide lubricant and cooling to the mechanical seal for heat dissipation. These double mechanical seals are devices that are used to provide a seal at the point of entry or exit of a rotating shaft. Sometimes we are handling precious fluids, so that precious fluids also we cannot waste. Therefore, these double mechanical seals are provided to ensure that your process fluid should be preserved and safe inside of the pump. Double mechanical seals are proven and reliable to cater the need to stop pollution in the environment due to hazardous liquid or saving precious liquids. Why double mechanical seal? A question comes in our mind. Why not single mechanical seal is enough and why we would like to use double mechanical seal? As I earlier explained that double mechanical seals are used to prevent pollution into the atmosphere. A picture is shown of a pump where you can see a water is leaking from a sniffing box. As we know, gland packings are not reliable. Therefore, mechanical seals are used in place of gland packings where we need to confirm that there should not be any leakage from a sniffing box into the atmosphere. So what are the benefits of this double mechanical seal? Prevent leakage into atmosphere to meet safety requirements as well as economy of liquid waste. Priming problems of pumps are solved. In gland packings, as we know, air can be sucked into the pump. Long life of seal increase running hours of pump and reduce downtime, so that increase productivity of the plant. The seal also make corrosion free surrounding area of pump motor and structures, because if there is not leakage into the atmosphere, then your structures of the pump and motor can be saved. Seal may use water as a lubricant, so neutralize abrasives and salts. Layout of double mechanical seal. A picture of a double mechanical seal is shown where you can see layout of a double mechanical seal. Here you can see this is an inside primary seal which is shown here, and this is a outside secondary seal which is towards atmosphere. This inside seal is immersed in process liquid in a stuffing box, and this outside seal is cooled by buffer fluid from buffer supply tank enters via the inlet port, and this is an outlet port from where buffer fluid warmed by seal generated heat returns to buffer supply tank. Double mechanical seals can be either pressurized or non-pressurized depending upon artificial environment that is provided to exist between the seals. A non-pressurized dual seal, also known as a tandem arrangement, that we'll discuss in our next slide. Unpressurized double mechanical seal. you can see a picture of a double mechanical seal which is unpressurized. That arrangement is shown in the slide. A dual unpressurized seal uses a buffer fluid at or near atmospheric pressure to lubricate the atmospheric side seal. Externally supplied fluid at a pressure lower than the pump seal chamber pressure used as a lubricant and or diluent in a dual unpressurized seal is called buffer fluid. The buffer fluid pressure is significantly less than the seal chamber pressure, so any leakage occurring across the process side seal will leak into the buffer fluid. This arrangement is very common in applications containing hazardous liquids as it can potentially reduce the leakage to the environment greatly. Here in this slide, you can see this is a process side seal, this one, and this is an atmospheric side seal. So here a buffer liquid which is shown here, this is a buffer liquid which has been provided from outside. So this is your pump liquid, this is your buffer fluid, and this is your atmospheric side. So if any leakage from pump fluid will occur due to failure of this inboard seal, then this will come only up to this buffer liquid, not into the atmosphere. So in case we are handling hazardous liquid, it can reduce leakage to the environment. Pressurized double mechanical seal. A picture of a pressurized double mechanical seal is shown. That arrangement you can see in this slide. Dual pressurized seal uses a barrier fluid, same fluid as dual unpressurized, at a pressure 25 psi 1.75 bar above seal chamber pressure to lubricate the seals. This pressure can be more than this also, depending upon the process side pressure. Externally supplied fluid at a pressure above the pump seal chamber pressure introduced into a dual pressurized seal to isolate the process fluid completely from the environment is called barrier fluid. Since the barrier fluid pressure is higher than the seal chamber pressure, any leakage occurring at the process side seal will enter the pump through inboard seal. So here you can see a picture of an inboard seal. If any failure occurs in the inboard seal, in this seal, then this barrier fluid, this will enter into the pump side, because the pressure of the barrier fluid is higher than the process fluid pressure. Therefore, this will not allow this process fluid to go outside to the atmosphere. Since the barrier fluid pressure is higher than the seal chamber pressure, any leakage occurring at the process side seal will enter the pump through inboard seal, and you can know that your pump flow will increase. In case your inboard seal is failed, then what happened? Your sealant pressure or a barrier fluid will enter into the pump and will increase the flow of the discharge of the pump flow. This arrangement, when working properly, assure no leakage of the pump fluid to atmosphere. Seal configurations. There are various ways seal faces are configured, arranged in double mechanical seals. So what are that arrangements? Back to back, tandem, and face to face. So let us see all the arrangements one by one. Back to back arrangement of double mechanical seal. A picture of back to back arrangement of double mechanical seal is shown. The back to back layout, so called because the two seals are placed literally back to back, gives the possibility to create a barrier made of a pressurized auxiliary fluid not harmful to the environment. In this sketch, you can see the two seal faces are opposite to each other. This is a inboard seal and this is outboard seal. So both the seal faces are opposite to each other. This arrangement is called back-to-back arrangement. The lubrication of seal faces are done by a barrier fluid which is generally more than 1 bar or 15 psi process fluid. In this kind of arrangement, as the barrier fluid pressure is more than the 1 bar of the process fluid, and if this outboard seal fail, then this barrier fluid is lost, and due to losing of this barrier fluid, this seal face will also open of inside seal, and both the seals will fail simultaneously. This type of design is called unbalanced design of back-to-back arrangement. A balanced design of back-to-back arrangement is also used where a barrier fluid is used of more than 1 bar of system pressure and a buffer fluid is used for outboard seal here, which is less than the seal chamber pressure. In that case, if outboard seal fail, this buffer fluid will be lost, but because the seal chamber pressure will remain, hence both the seal faces will remain closed due to barrier fluid and seal will work reliably. If inboard seal will fail, the process flow of pump discharge will increase, will indicate you that inboard seal is failed. And if your outboard seal will fail, this seal will fail, then your buffer tank, which is mounted here, this level of this buffer tank will decrease, will also you indicate that your outboard seal is failed. Tandem arrangement of double mechanical seal. A sketch of tandem arrangement of double mechanical seal is shown. In this configuration, the two seals are assembled with the same orientation. The configuration is also called in series arrangement or face to back arrangement. This arrangement is generally used in dual seals. The auxiliary fluid often is at a lower pressure than the process fluid, but also pressurized system can be implemented with suitable seal rings. If we are using a buffer fluid at atmospheric pressure, the buffer fluid tank will be provided and the buffer fluid will be supplied into the seal chamber here. In this arrangement, both the seals work independently. Therefore, in case one seal fails, inboard seal fails, suppose this is our inboard seal, then outboard seal will work independently and will take care of the system and will not allow any hazardous or toxic liquid to go into the atmosphere. If we are using a coolant or sealant fluid higher than system pressure, in that case, if your inboard seal, suppose this is your inboard seal, if it will fail, then your system pressure will go inside. This your sealant pressure will go inside the system, but your outboard seal will work independently and not allow any fluid to leakage into the environment outside. In case your outboard seal fails, this seal, then only your buffer fluid will go outside the environment and will not harm anything. Therefore, these seals are generally used where toxic or hazardous liquids are handled. Face-to-face arrangement of double mechanical seal. A sketch of face-to-face arrangement of double mechanical seal is shown, where you can see this is an inboard seal and this is an outboard seal. Both the seals are arranged in a face-to-face manner. It is composed by a unique central stationary ring. So the stationary ring is provided here. This is a stationary ring which is provided in the central, and two opposite rotary rings are provided in a pressurized and unpressurized system. It has some interesting features like reduced overall length. The length of the system is reduced due to face-to-face arrangement, and springs are not in contact with the process fluid. So this system is also generally used and give a reliable results. Thanks for watching the video. If you like this video, hit like button below, share it with your friends and colleagues, subscribe our channel for getting updates on upcoming videos. Please leave any comments, feedback to improve the videos. Thank you.